All right, Tony, we're here at a break at the analyst event, and you just got done presenting. A couple things you highlighted. You talked a lot about a culture of innovation. What does that mean at Siemens PLM and at Siemens in general?
Well, it's really, really important for us. I mean, at the end of the day, innovation is our lifeblood. What our team does every day, every week, every month, every year is innovation. And being part of Siemens, it also has a culture of innovation. So our fit with Siemens was perfect.
The other thing you touched on, you say a lot when you speak about we never let a customer fail, our commitment to customers. But what you shared today was interesting because you shared a little bit more behind that. What does that really mean? It's not just a motto. Can you just elaborate for folks that weren't in the room today? What do you mean by that?
Yeah, for us, we walk through a simple 6 or 7 step process of what we mean about never let a customer fail. It's inculcated in our culture. It's a process for us. It's just not a set of words. What we look at is understanding the customer's requirement. Then we look at, we know we have capability. Does our capability meet that requirement? If not, when can we do it? Then we go into a contracting process with a customer, a very important process where we do not sign the contract unless we're sure that we can meet the requirement, meet the commitment. And then we go into a process of monitoring. We go into our technical review boards, our MRBs, where we go in with our team and the customer, our sales team, our R&D team, for example, and we talk over the implementation process. How are things going? What's on the horizon? Do we need to make any changes to the plan?
And you particularly highlighted systems engineering as being a place where we're winning business. Why are we winning business there? Why are we uniquely positioned?
System engineering is really important because as you look at a product, there's many disciplines in our product of our customer. Take an automobile. You have all the different subsystems. You know, the drivetrain, the interior, the instrument cluster, the body systems, suspension systems. All these systems need to work together. And as they add more and more electronics, more and more software to the vehicle, you have mechanical systems, hydraulic systems, software system, electronic systems. So integrating that all into a capability where we can help the customers understand the systems engineering and the functioning and the way those things work and interact with each other, and then accessing the information, being able to share that information across all the different people who need it. This creates a system engineering capability that when the customer goes into a benchmark between us and our competitors, we wind up winning because our system engineering capability is far superior to any of our competitors.